Dear students, good morning all. I think you are all well by the grace of Almighty and staying at home safe and sound. By this time we have already learnt a lot about online classes and we have also learnt many things from these classes with the students, with the teachers of Uposwar College are trying our level best to inform you about your syllabus and your academic activities. We are all looking forward to having a nice time and we are all eagerly waiting for classroom learning and teaching. We are hopeful that within a short time, God will be with us and we will get rid of the serious or fatal disease, namely coronavirus or COVID-19. So, we are looking for the best and you all will pray to Almighty so that He relieves us from the curse of this incurable disease. However, let's now go to action. Today, I will once again share English second paper with you, as I have been doing since the beginning of online class. Today, we will discuss voice, a very popular term and which is, I think, you are well known because it had been on your syllabus while you were in your school life. So, you know some primary conception about voice. I think you know voice is of two kinds, active and passive. Active means where the subject is directly involved with the action. That is where the action is done by the subject himself or itself. On the other hand, passive means where the subject is not active, rather he enjoys the effect or the action done by the subject. Here, the subject does not take part in action, rather he enjoys the result or effect of the action done by the subject. So, this is the difference between active and passive. Active means the work which is directly performed by the subject himself, whereas passive means where the subject does not take part in action but he enjoys the result or effect of the action done by the subject. Today, we will learn active to passive. So, at first, notice the rule. It has a common rule. What is the rule? At first, we will have to bring object and it will have to be changed into object. That is, we will have to change object into subject. Then we will use auxiliary verb. Notice, this is very important because it varies from tense to tense and all other rules remain unchanged, but this portion changes according to tense. So, if you want to do well in voice sense, then you will have a good command over tenses. Unless and until you know tense well, then it will be difficult on your part to have good command over voice sense itself. So, at first we will turn object into subject, then we will use auxiliary verb according to tense and person. It varies from tense and person. Then we will use V3, then rest of the sentence, then by the object of the subject. At the end, we will write object of the subject. But sometimes we can also write rest of the sentence at the end of the sentence. So, notice again, at first we will turn object into subject, then we will use auxiliary verb. It is very important, it will have to be used according to tense and person, then V3, then past, rest of the sentence, then by, then object of the subject. Now, notice, if the tense is present infinite, then the auxiliary verb will be am, is, or are. It depends on the subject. If the subject is I, then the auxiliary verb will be am. If the subject is he or we or the cow, third person singular, then it will be his, and then are. If the subject is you, then it will be are, or third person plural, the boys, the kites, and so on. Birds, then the verb will be are. So, you will attentively, carefully use auxiliary verb depending on tense and person. And so, this is very important. For example, we play football for enjoyment. This is present indefinite tense because here the verb is in present form. When the verb will be in present form, then we will consider it present indefinite. So at first we will turn object into subject, football. Then we will use an auxiliary verb, an is are. So football takes is after it. Then V3 of Pele is played. Then rest of the sentence for enjoyment, then by, then object of the subject, us. The object of we is us. So the answer will be football is played for enjoyment by us. Then the second example, he teaches us English. You notice here we have got two objects. This is called direct, this is indirect. But one thing you should keep in mind, that the object is normally or almost every time after verb. Maybe the sentence is a long one, you need not to be worried. You will find subject at the beginning, then verb, then object, then rest of the sentence. But in this case, we have two objects, us and English. English is direct object and us is indirect object. So you can take one of these objects as subject, but it is better to take the object which is related to person. We should take the object which is related to person, but you can also take this. Any one of these will do. But my suggestion is that you will always take the object which is after verb. Then you will not make any mistake in other cases. Or if you want to take English, then you may face problem in some cases, because you will remember that the object is almost after verb. So this is verb and us is object. So if we turn us into subject, it will be we, then auxiliary verb are, then V3, the V3 of teachers is taught, then rest of the sentence English, by him. So the answer will be, we are taught English by him. So where the object is? The object is, keep in mind, almost every time it is after verb, but some exception, we may face some exception, but without those exceptions, this object is always after verb, subject, verb and object. Sometimes we make mistake because in the school level we taught, but the teachers taught you that object is at the end of the sentence, but it is a wrong idea, it is a wrong conception. The object is always or almost always after verb. This is the main rule and main theory. So don't think that the object is always at the end. It is not correct. Now, present continuous tense. Here, auxiliary verb will be am being, is being, and are being. How will you recognize a present continuous tense? A present continuous tense must have am is a, and then ing with the principal verb. When you will see am is a, and then ing with the principal verb, then you will consider it as present continuous tense. But the rule is almost same. At first, subject of the object. Then, this is the main point. This is the place where we or the students make mistake. Kites, plural, so are. Then being, why being? Since it is a present continuous tense, present continuous tense always take am being, is being, or are being. Then V3, what is V? Flying. The V3 of flying is flown, then rest of the sentence in the sky, by, then object of the subject as. So the answer will be, kites are being flown in the sky by us. The rule is almost unchanged, but this portion, that is auxiliary verb, will change according to tense. So before going to solve tense ways, you need to focus on this point. They are flying a pennant. It is also present continuous because there is are, then ing with the principal verb. Here object is a canal. A canal is then being, then V3, the V3 of digging is dug by subject, object of the subject, then. So the answer will be, a canal is being dug by them. Today we will learn the last lesson, last tense, that is present perfect tense. How will we recognize a present perfect tense? A present perfect tense must have either have or has, and then V3. Have or has, and then it will be have or has will be followed by V3. Now notice, she has, here we have has, then V3 of invited me to the party. Here the object is me, not the party. Sometimes we take the party because we have learned that the object is at the end of the sentence, but this is a wrong idea, not the party, but me. And if we turn me into subject, it will be I, then have been, I always take have been, V3, invited to the party by her. Here we get an advantage, that the advantage is that here V3 is always given. Always we find V3 in place of present perfect tense. So it will be have been, then V3 invited to the party by her. The last example I have written rice. Here object is rice, then has been, then V3 eaten by object of the subject, that is me. So the answer will be rice has been eaten by me. So I think you have got some idea about how we can transfer active into passive. That is all from today's class. We will meet next time. Till then, thank you.